you, my dear students. Today's topic is, it is a part of modal verbs or modals. Today we will discuss, I will explain you the modal verb must and ought to, O-U-G-H-T, ought to. These two modal verbs will be explained by me in this session. Please listen carefully, my dear students. Already in previous classes, I have completed in detailed explanation about the will, would, shall, should, can, could, may, might. That means 8 modal verbs I have completed in 4 sessions, four sessions in 4 classes. This is the part 5 and 5th session number 5. In this session, we will discuss modal verbs, part of the modal verbs, must and to. Two modal verbs will be explained by me in detail, my dear students. Okay, modal verb must, we should understand, all the students, modal verb must, it is one of the, among the 13 modal verbs, all of the modal verbs are 13 in number. Must is used, it is to express our obligation, very important, obligation. The function of the language, function of the must, obligation, and give advice. Basically, the primary duty, we should construct the sentence. The main important use or function of the must is obligation. It expresses an obligation. It can be used for a present and future reference. Present and future reference. In the past, when we have to tell something in the past obligation, we should use instead of must, had to. It is the past form of the must. Had to. Please remember this one. Please don't forget. Had to. We will discuss here about the must, one of the modal verb. It is an act or course. What is the obligation? It expresses to obligation. Through the must, we express our obligation. What is the meaning of obligation? Obligation means an act of course, which a person is morally or legally bound. It is a duty. Obligation means it is a duty. It is a commitment. Obligation means commitment. It is a commitment. That should be more important when we should frame the sentence must. The function of the must is mainly obligation. The state of being forced to do something because it is your duty. It is your duty. That is the obligation. Must is used to express obligation or to give advice in the present or the future reference. If you want to say in the past obligation, we have to use had to. It is the past form of the must. That is important, my dear student. And then, what is the usage of the must? How to use the general usage of the must? For example, affirmative sentence, we have to frame, or declarative sentence, or statement. Must comes first in the verb phrase. It follows the main verb. All modal verbs follows the main verb. Modal verb follows the main verb also. इट कम्स बिफोर आफ्टर द सब्जेक्ट बिफोर द मेन वर्ब दट ईज द अफर्मेटिव सेंटेंस आर स्टेटमेंट फॉर एग्जांपल वी शुड डिस्कस अबाउट द एग्जांपल्स थ्रू द एग्जांपल्स वी शुड अंडरस्टैंड फॉर एग्जांपल दिस मस्ट बी शी मस्ट बी योर सिस्टर शी मस्ट हैव लॉट्स ऑफ फ्रेंड्स फॉर एग्जांपल शी मस्ट हैव लॉट्स ऑफ फ्रेंड्स इट इज अफर्मेटिव सेंटेंस सब्जेक्ट प्लस वर्ब दिस इज वर्ब फ्रेज मस्ट प्लस वी वन हैव इज फंक्शंस एज ए मेन वर्ब हियर नॉट ए हेल्पिंग वर्ब शी मस्ट हैव पोसेस ओन ही मस्ट हैव लॉट ऑफ फ्रेंड्स दट मीन्स इट इज ए अफर्मेटिव सेंटेंस इट इज ए पॉजिटिव सेंटेंस वी शुड यूज मस्ट शी मस्ट हैव लॉट ऑफ फ्रेंड्स मस्ट मीन्स मोडल वर्ब प्लस ऑलवेज फॉलो द वी वर्ब वर्ब इट कम्स बिटवीन द सब्जेक्ट अंड मेन वर्ब दट इज मोर इंपॉर्टेंट सब्जेक्ट अंड मेन वर्ब इन बिटवीन इट इज असर्टिव फॉर्म आर डिक्लेरेटिव फॉर्म वेर यूजिंग द मस्ट अंड देन वाट इज द नेगेटिव फॉर्म द नेगेटिव फॉर्म ऑफ द मस्ट इज मस्टेंट सा इट इज ए कॉन्ट्रैक्ट फॉर्म मस्टेंट ईज ए नेगेटिव फॉर्म दट ईज देर फॉर एग्जांपल देर मस्ट बी एनी रबिश फॉर एग्जांपल देर मस्टेंट एनी रबिश दे मस्टेंट एनी रबिश लेफ्ट वी शुड नॉट लेफ्ट द रबिश देर मस्टेंट Any rubbish left. Mustn't is a contracted form. What is the full form? There must not any rubbish. Full form is must not. What is the difference? When do you use must full form and contracted form? Expansion form. We can use the full form. Must not. In formal context, must not in formal context. That means expansion form or full form must not. Formal context. And when we want to emphasize something, on that time we also use must not. That means full form instead of contracted form. Mustn't. For example, you must leave this place. We should emphasize. You should emphasize. For example, negative sentence, you must not leave. Negative form, sorry. We should, negative sentence, not positive sentence. You must not leave this place. You must not leave any rubbish here. Must not leave any rubbish here means we emphasize. We strongly said that thing. That is the more important between the contracted form and the full form by the students. And must, how to form the question form, interrogative sentence? It is also useful to frame the interrogative sentence. Must you make that noise? Must you make that noise? That you, question mark. Why is it yes or no type question? Inverted question. Subject, verb have been interchanged. In the place of subject, the verb must. In the place of verb, the subject must be there. Must you make that noise? It is interrogative form. inverted question using the modal verb must. We can use must even also in the question tag also. Question tag. Question tag. We can use must or mustn't. Both are in the question tag. For example, the house, H-O-U-S-C, the house must be, the house must be worth, millions, lakhs of rupees. This is a positive statement, we already known. The positive statement takes the negative question tag. It is a mini question. It is for confirmation. The house must be worth millions of rupees. Mustn't it? We have to take pronoun instead of the house noun. We always write the pronoun in question tag or many question. For the confirmation, it is used. The must, the house must be worth millions of rupees. Mustn't it? You must not leave. You must not leave any rubbish. Must you? It is a negative question. Negative statement take positive tag. Positive statement take negative tag, my dear students. That is more important you have to understand. And then what is the necessary to know about the must? What are the uses of the must? Uses, what are the functions of the must? What are the functions of the must? When we think carefully and facts, we often use must to express deductions. Deductions. In mathematical term, deductions are entirely different from deduction. Deductions means a fact. Here the deduction means, in English grammar, in this terminology, in this context, and deduction means we come to one conclusion. That is the deduction. Conclusion. Conclusion. That is the deduction. Conclusion. What is the meaning of deduction? Conclusion. Conclusion. When we think carefully and facts, we often use must to express deductions. We must to express our deductions and conclusions from these. What is the meaning of deduction in this context? This is inference. The inference of particular instances by reference to the law or principle or general principle. You came into conclusion by reasoning. That is the deduction. We came into conclusion by reasoning. After thinking, we come to conclusion. We come to a conclusion. That is the deductions. For example, we use must. He falls asleep. He falls in class. Every first period. Every first period. One of the student, he always sleeping in the classroom in the beginning of the first period. At the first period. We have seen many times. The particular incidents. We have the reference also there. It is a general principle. By reasoning, we come to conclusion. That is called deduction. We come into conclusion. He must fall asleep in class every day. That is the use of the must, my dear students, deductions. And we use to deny something to make negative deductions. What is negative deductions? How to frame the sentence in negative deductions? In negative deductions, negative conclusion, we should not use generally must. We use can't or cannot expansion form, cannot. We make negative deductions or conclusions, we use can't or cannot to deny something. For example, she cannot be sister, deduction. We have to analyze one of the girl, we have seen who is going there. We come to a conclusion, we utter the negative statement. For example, she cannot, his sister, she cannot, his sister. One of the girl is coming, we are discussing in our friends, she cannot, his sister. She cannot, his sister. How do you say she looks different, so different, she looks so different. Because why we come to conclusion or deduction, a negative statement we use, we don't use must, you use cannot or can't. She can't his sister, he can't his sister, he can't be his sister. She looks so different. That means we should not use must in negative, must into a negative statement, negative deduction. Instead of that, we use cannot or can't. We should use can't in negative deduction. Negative deductions, negative conclusions by reasoning, we use can't, not mustn't or must not. Then what is the function of the must? Another thing, must express strong obligation. Must expresses strong obligation. Strong obligation. Strong obligation and necessity. Obligation means compulsory. Necessity. For example, we must talk about the new project. Example, I will write you example. We must talk about the new project. This is the statement. We express strong obligation, strong necessity. It's compulsory we do that work. We must talk, we will discuss, we must talk about the new project. It is the present tense or future, we will use must. If you use obligation in the past, or necessity, strong obligation, it is important work of the must. You must talk about the new project, strong obligation. It is necessary to talk. It is a need. It is compulsory. That means we use the must. But while using the, express our view, strong obligation in the past tense, we should use had to instead of must. Had to. It is a past form of the must. We use had to express obligation and necessity in the past. For example, in the last year, what happened? It is already completed action. The teachers had to make report on each child every week. The teachers had to make report on every child. Had to make is a past action. Last year, we should observe the adverb of time. If you want to say obligation or necessity in the past tense, we should do the had to. We should use had to. Last year, the teachers had to make report on each child every week. It is not possible to write the entire sentence, my dear sir. Please understand. I should write on the screen only main points also. You should understand. Don't confuse. Okay. Next, we use must not to talk about what is not permitted or rule. Negative, mustn't or must not, or must not, when do we use? What is not permitted? It is a rule, it is a law. At the public places, we must use must not. We should use must not. For example, you must not make noise in the classroom. You must not park opposite of my house. You must not park your vehicles in front of my house. Your vehicles in front of my house. You must not park your vehicles here. It is a public place or in front of the houses. It is inconvenience to park if you park there. That's why, what is the expression? We use must not to talk about what is not permitted. It is a rule. It is a law. What is the rule in the classroom? All the students, we will express, you must not make noise when I am teaching. I will make a rule. You are not permitted to talk in this period. That is the expression of the mustn't we should express, my dear students. And we must is also to express polite encouragement. These functions should be done by the must. We should use the functions of the must is to express our polite invitation, to express our encouragement to our friends. For example, you must come and see us soon. You must come and see soon. It is a polite invitation. We use the expression must. The function of the must. One more function is encouragement. Encouragement. For example, you must go and see that film. Why? Because I have already seen that film. It is a very good film. It is informative film. You must go and see and watch that film. It is an encouragement. Through my experience, I made a statement. That is the more important of the functions of the must also. What is the difference between must and have to is a present, must is also present. What is the past form of the have to, had to? Difference between the phrase have to does not look like a modal verb. It is not look like a modal verb, have to. But it performs the same function as a modal verb, have to. We will discuss must and have to. What is the difference between must and have to? Must and have to, it performs the same functions as a modal verb. Have to can play the role of must. In the past tense, we should use had to. It is the past form of the must. You should understand. It is main point, my dear student. These words can often be used. In the language. Interchangeably. Often we used interchangeably. What are the interchangeable? Must, have to. Both are same meaning. Must, have to. Interchangeably. Often they are often can be used interchangeably in English language. But what is the main difference between the must and have to? Between the must and have to, what is the main difference? These are have to can be emotional context. Must means obligation to do something. Have to means emotional context. Emotional context. This is must is obligation. Obligation or necessity. You should understand that thing. It have to implies that obligation comes from someone else. Must expresses the speaker's feelings, whereas have to express above all. That is the difference between the must and have to, my dear students. For example, through the example, I will explain you. I have to pay the bills. I have to pay. I have to pay the bills or the medical bills. I have to submit my medical bills in the office. In the office. This is have to. Have to is to implies that express the speakers above all feelings. Emotional context. Whereas must is obligation. For example, it is an emotional context. I have to submit my bills in the office. I have to submit in the bills, the emotional context. But must is a obligatory context, obligation. I must stop smoking. It is obligatory. The different, you should analyze the difference. You should comprehend the difference between the must and have to. I must stop smoking. What is the reason? It is really bad for my health. It is really bad for my health. It is really bad for my health. Because I must stop smoking. I must stop smoking. It is obligatory. It is necessity. It is compulsory. That is the difference between the must and have to, my dear students. And must in negative form, must expresses, in negative form, must expresses a strict prohibition. We should understand that one. A strict prohibition. A strict prohibition. In negative form, when you use the must in negative form, it indicates the function of the language is a strict prohibition. Strict prohibition. For example, you must not smoke here. This is one example. You must not smoke. You must not smoke here. It is prohibited to smoke here. That is the function of the you mustn't not. You must not, you mustn't smoke here. In negative form, must expresses a strict prohibition. The example is, you mustn't smoke here. You must not smoke here. The same sentence, difference between, I will explain you, have to and must not. For example, you don't have to pay for this. For example, you don't have to pay for this. What is the meaning? That means you must not to pay for this. Instead of we don't have to pay. Have to have used here. What is the difference between that you must not pay for this? You don't have to pay for this. You must not pay for this means it is obligatory, it is necessary, it is compulsory.
You don't have to pay for this means you are not obligated to do something. But you can do it if you want to do or not. That is main difference, my dear students. That is the main difference. The main difference, that is obligatory. This is not obligated. You are not obligated to do something. But you can do it if you wanted to do. It is an emotional contest. That is an obligational contest. Must is an obligation contest. That is the difference between the must and have to. You should understand, my teacher, in language functions. And must expresses submission to general laws. Submission to general laws. General laws, something needs to be done. Something needs to, we need to do something on the time we use must. This is one of the function of the must. Must expresses submission to various general laws. General laws. Submission of general law. It is something needs to be done. Needs to be done. It is a general law. It applies to all the public. For example, all the public. It is related to all the public. On that time we express, we use must. It is useful. For example, we must, as employees, government employees, or we are earning some more. We must pay taxes. We must pay taxes. That means, what is the function of this modal verb here? Must plus V1, we must pay taxes. We must pay taxes means it expresses the submission to various general laws. It is something to be done. Compulsory, it is something to be done. We did not escape from this duty. We should not deviate from this duty. We must pay taxes. That is more important, my dear students. The same sentence we have to use instead of must. He has to tell. He has to tell truth. Truth. He has to tell truth. He has to tell. Have to. Third person singular, we have to has, not have. He has to tell the truth. The truth. At this moment. He has to tell the truth at the moment instead of must. He must to tell. That is entirely different obligation. He has to tell the truth at this moment. It expresses submission to a private law. That is, you are following your conscience. It is your conscience. It is your principle. It is your duty. It is a mental process. It is not compulsory. Whether you follow or not. If you wanted to do, you can do. You have to, for example, you have to tell the truth at this time. But you must tell the truth. That means it is obligatory. It is compulsory, it is necessary. That is the difference between the must and have to, my dear students. And then we go to the next, already some of the examples are there here. You should understand, my dear students. The rule for use of modal must is that it is used to express obligation. We are already discussed all these obligation, our duty, that means duty, necessity, these are all common synonyms. Compulsion also synonyms. Prohibition, we are prohibited. Emphatic advice, you, that determination, and then assumption, we come to a conclusion. Assumption means conclusion or a deduction. With some reasoning, we come to conclusion, the difference, conclusion or interference. Certainty or strong possibility. These are the functions of the must. Some of the examples, only simple examples are there. So, द चिल्ड्रन मस्ट ओबे देयर पेरेंट्स. दिस इज द ड्यूटी. This is a duty, moral obligation. The children must obey their parents. This is one of the example. And then we must not steal money from anyone. We don't cheat anyone. We must be very honesty. We must not steal. Steal means theft. STEL. STEL, steal means metal. Money from anyone. And next one, you must follow the orders of your boss. This is more important, my dear students. This is more important. This one is, you must follow the orders of your boss, your head of the department. Every employee, not only government or private, every subordinate, you should habituate. You must follow the orders given by your boss or your head of the institute, your superior. This is the first duty of the any person, any man who is doing as a subordinate. It is a good quality. We must follow the orders of our boss. It is our duty. That is more important, using the must. And next example, I must reach work on time. It is necessity. On time, in time. It is a preposition, it comes. On time means exactly time. In time means just before time. When we are discussing about the prepositions, we will tell you. I will explain you. I must reach work on time. It is a necessity. It is compulsory. It is need. And next example, you must do as I say, compulsion. It is also obligation. You must do as I say, as I am directed, you do your work. That is the compulsion. And you must not smoke in public places. This is a public area, it is a prohibited action. You must not smoke in public places, it is a prohibition action. We never smoke in public places. It is discomfort to others. So, my dear students, next you understand next examples. And you must see a dentist at once. Emphatic advice. Emphatic means a strong advice. Any deviation, it is not at all to deviate from that. We give our friend an advice. This is called advice means advice, advice. It is a verb form, is a noun form. Verb form is advise, noun form is advice. That is the utterance of the correct pronunciation. You must see a dentist at once. It is emphatic advice. Strong advice, my dear students. On that time, we use the must. We must not go before they come back. Determination. It is a rule. We must not go there before they come back. It is a condition. And next, the students must be in their classes at this time. Strong probability. We are thinking probability. The students must be in their classes at this time. We are thinking, I express, I predict, I imagination, my students must be in our classrooms at this time. That is strong probability. He must be 40 years old, assumption. He must be 40 years old, assumption. What is that meaning, my dear students? You should understand the meaning. Emphatic means forcibly and clearly. Assumption. He must be 40 years assumption. It is come under the language function assumption. A thing that is accepted, a belief, a thing that is accepted as true or as certain to happen without proof. A belief, it is a belief, assumption means a belief. Assumption means belief, a belief or feeling that something is true or something that will happen. Although there is no proof, without proof we are thinking like that. It is a belief, it is a truth. Although there is no proof, it is called an assumption. He must be 40 years old. We are expecting 40 years old. Next example. He must have left by now. Certainty compulsory. Definitely. He must have left by now. Okay, my dear children, I have completed the usage of the must. And then we go to the next topic. Ought. It is more important. Ought. Okay. O-U-G-H-T. Ought. One of the modal verb, ought, it follows the two. It is entirely different. Ought is entirely different. What is different? Ought to is semi-modal verb. It is also called semi-modal. Because it is the same as ways like a modal verb and as somewhere like a main verb. That is why it is called a semi-modal verb. Semi-modal verbs. The verbs which are coming, semi-modal verbs. Some of the semi-modal verbs are there in English language. Purely modal, semi-modal. Ought to, need to, dare to, use it to. The four verbs. Ought to, need to, use to, dare. These four modal verbs called semi-modal verbs. Because why they are called semi-modal verbs? They are functions as a modal verb as well as a main verb. That is, they are called semi-modal verb. I ought to phone my parents. For example, an assertive sentence, I have framing, ought to, O-U-G-H-T, ought to. I ought to phone my parents. My ought to phone my parents means I must do that activity. It is a positive sentence. If negative sentence is we ought not to do exercises. We ought not to phone my parents. Ought not to phone my parents. That is a negative sentence. For example, note here, what is the important note here? We should remember. The negative of the ought is not to, we should use should not. Instead of ought not to, we should not is commonly used in negative sentence. The same meaning. The meaning is not changed. Commonly we have to use it. Usually you use should not instead of the ought not. You should remember that. If you express a negative statement, we use instead of must not, you should not use. We should not use. For example, you should not speak to your father like that. He should behave irregularly, harshly. On that time, we give an advice. You should not speak to your father. You should not speak to your father like that. The same meaning. You ought not speak to your father like that. Instead of ought not, we use should not in negative sentences. That is one of the rule of the, my dear students. And questions, we are framing the question. Ask she to call the phone, interrogative sentence, question. Ought we to be more worried about the environment? Ought we to be more worried about the environment? It is a interrogative sentence. We use ought to. Generally, the question form of ought to is not very common. It is very formal. We should frame the question form or interrogative sentence. It is very formal, more formal. But we usually use should. If you frame the question in the place of ought, we should use the should. Instead of ought. For example, if you frame the interrogative sentence, should we feel difficult to listen this class? Should we feel difficult to listen this class? Instead of ought we to feel difficult to listen this class? We use in interrogative formation, instead of using ought, we use should, modal verb. That is more important. And we use ought when we are telling about things which are desired or idea. That is one of the occasion, one of the functions. Our idea or desired idea should be expressed using the ought to, the modal verb. What is the desired idea, desired thinking? For example, we ought to eat lots of fruits. We ought to eat lots of fruits. Why? Because it gives good health. We ought to eat, it is a desired concept, idea, our thought. On that time, we use ought to. We ought to eat lots of fruits and vegetables. Lots of fruits and vegetables every day to maintain the good health. That is the statement we have to use. We express our feeling, desired feeling. We are telling about things which are desired feeling or idea, we should ought to. And we can use ought to when we talk about what is likely probable. On that time we use also ought to. For example, there ought to be some good films this weekend. This weekend, so they ought to be, I should not write complete sentence. I will express you, listen carefully. There ought to be some good films at this weekend. That means our probability, likely to be happen. That function also should be expressed by the ought to, my dear students. Ought to or should, what is the difference? Ought to and should are similar meaning. They are similar meaning. Should, S-H-Y-U-L-D, should and ought to, they are similar meaning. But should is more common than ought to. Ought to is more formal. Ought to is more formal than should. There ought to be more street lights here. For example, there OUGHT ought to be more street lights here. That means the same sentence, instead of ought to, we use there should be more street lights here. What is the difference? Ought to be expression is more formal than should we using. This is less formal. For example, I ought to walk daily. I am so fat. That means the same as really should. I should walk regularly. For example, I ought to walk daily because I am so fat. Instead of ought to, it is more formal. We should use should. That means the same as really, I should walk daily or regularly because I am so fat. That is more important. And to express our obligation that something should be, we should use should instead of ought to also. For example, you ought to listen carefully. You ought to listen carefully. This is obligation. You ought to listen carefully. I will made a statement. You ought to leave now. This place you ought to leave now. You ought to tell the truth. You ought to apologize. All the teachers ought to learn more. This is obligation. This is duty. To express our obligation that someone we should do, we are using the ought to also instead of must. And you use it to say what you advisable, recommendable. I will give advisable and recommended. Then using the recommend or advisable we used to ought to. This is one more function of the ought to. This is delicious. You ought to try some. We ought to be living now. For example, I will write here, we ought to be living. We ought to be living now. This is recommended. You ought to have come to this meeting. It is very interesting. The meeting is very interesting. You ought to come. We are recommended. We are advised. That is all the functions of the ought to, my dear students. And before concluding, complete this session, one of the examples I will do here. The rule for use of modal will is that ought to. Use it to express the subject's obligation or duty, and it is used as give advice also. For examples, we have given few examples. I ought to love my parents. It is obligation, our duty is a moral duty. We ought to love our parents. We ought to love our parents. Love my children. Love our children. It is obligation or duty. And then we ought not to cheat anyone. Ought not cheat. We should not cheat anyone. That is one duty, our duty. You ought to practice for more than 2 hours a day if you want to clear the exam. You want to get more and score a good score, you have to practice more than 2 hours a day. That is one of the examples. And my dear students, all of you, goodbye. We will meet again in the next class. Thank you, everybody.